Listen, I never think that a man should hit a woman. However, there's some times where y'all be wilding and not everybody's going to feel that way. So you should probably be careful before you get got. Body cam shows a woman punching Baltimore cop twice before another one knocks her out. Oh, no. Let us dive in. Let us see what happens. Oh, boy.
What you're going to see first in the video is Sergeant Craig Heagley's body worn camera video. Again, he's at the intersection of Baltimore Avenue and Gay Street when he observes a vehicle coming towards him. As you notice, the red light has gone red for the northbound traffic. The car comes through the intersection towards the officer, then makes a turn, doing a U-turn.
Wait, okay, I'm already confused as to what is happening. Why is this? What are you doing?
Back towards the sergeant, who then pulls out his firearm, order the driver out of the vehicle.
Okay, now, just in case somebody thinks that this is over the top because he pulled his fire, I do not disagree with him. As soon as a car goes past you and they start looping and acting weird and they're almost like they're coming, you don't know what this person's doing. If they're drunk on drugs, you've got to protect yourself. I'm still confused as to what kind of maneuvers they were making and why. Move your arm. I can't see. Okay, the audio starts in about 15 seconds. So there's probably, here's the thing. Whenever the audio doesn't start, I assume it's not just, oh, there was swear words. I assume it's because the cop is also saying some stuff that maybe he's not supposed to say. I don't know. I'm always curious why it's like, hey, there's no audio until this point when they're clearly having a conversation. But, you know, whatever. Let's find out. And I'm not hating on this cop.
He reholsters his weapon.
He's doing the right thing.
And approaches the driver, closes the door.
What is she doing?
Yeah, we might need another unit here. Sitting her spitting on us.
Okay, she's Baltimore not all. She's not all there. Something's wrong.
Don't touch me!
You're not going to the car.
Don't touch me!
Okay, so a number of things is happening. She's not drunk. This is not drunk, I don't think. I mean, maybe. Maybe she's really. But I'm thinking she took some kind of drugs and is not agreeing with her system, or she's got some mental problems, or it's a mix of the both. But this is something is very off.
Don't touch me.
You're being video recorded.
Touch me. If you don't violate my rights, I'm not going to violate
yours. Hit me with your car.
Because you were in the way.
It's blocked.
You're stupid. Don't talk to me.
The officer makes a determination to take the driver into custody. As you can see, she strikes the officer and strikes him a second time, causing her backup officer, Officer Love, who then struck.
I'm sorry. Listen, you can't just be swinging on people. I'm sorry. I'm still behind the, you know, yeah, Les, there's a lot of situations where a man can subdue a woman and should not hit a woman. However, you can't just take that as, oh, well, I could do this and get away with it because that's not cool. Yo, and I'm actually happy that it was a black officer. Otherwise, we already know this would have got really, really crazy. But listen, he said, you're not going to do that today. You're not.
The officer makes a determination to take the driver into custody. As you can see, she strikes the officer and strikes it a second time, causing her backup officer, Officer Love, who then struck the driver.
This man's pulling out his phone. The cop's like, you too late, bro. I already slept her. I mean, listen, there was another video we did where I was kind of against the cop hitting the lady because she tried to bite him, but I don't feel like she actually bit him. So I'm like, was the punch really necessary? But maybe she did bite him. I don't know. I'm not as much against that as I was initially. I still feel weird about it. I still kind of feel weird about it. And even in this situation, I can argue that the cop probably could have subdued her. He was behind her. He could have easily grabbed her arms, grabbed her up, tossed her on the ground, you know, whatever the case is. However, again, you have to consider, we are humans. We're human beings. There's only so much that people could take and go through in this and that before they lash out a little bit. And I understand that, yes, a police officer should have a higher gauge, a higher threshold that you have to go through before you ever get to that point. But it's like, I don't know. You know, they should have a higher threshold, but it doesn't mean that we should be testing that threshold, if that makes sense, right? Oh, boy. Listen, sometimes you just got to get put to sleep. You wake up, you'll be a better person for it.
Next, we're going to see Officer Emmer Berrios. He was a backup officer who arrived at the scene. Just from another vantage point, you could see.
Yo, KSI, y'all got to get this man on a Misfits card, please.
the struggle with the driver after Officer Love had struck her.
Hey, I got a woman here. She just punched me in the face 2 times. It's on body camera. She's fine.
Backup officers arrive, and a medic is called to take her in.
Yo, these officers are amazing in some of these videos. There was one where this dude did like a spin move into the situation. This officer had the greatest little, he's like, I'm professional. Professional. Yo, look at this man.
Arrive, and a medic is called
okay.
to take her in.
Okay.
To have her checked both mentally and physically.
She took 2 swings, hit me in the face. I'm fine. She's on the ground on her own volition, no force being used.
Okay, the cop lied, though. He said she's on the ground of her own volition, no force needed. It's like, no, your buddy just put her to sleep. Why don't you just tell the truth? I mean, I'm curious if he got in trouble for this. I'm curious. I feel like there's a chance he did.
She punched me in the face twice.
See, here's what, you know what makes me upset? I'm sorry, I'm just going to point this out. And it has nothing to do with these specific people on the corner, but it's with the majority of people in the world. Everyone gets, oh my God, the cop hit her because she hit him. You shouldn't have done it. She's a lady. This, I guarantee you, the same situation. This lady ran up on those people on the corner and started punching on one. Someone's going to hit her. Someone's going to hit her. People just like to take the freaking, I'm the justice warrior. It's just like, it's this role people want to take on instead of actually acknowledging the sequence of events and stuff. Yes, again, the cop probably could have subdued her. However, you're swinging at somebody. You can't do that. You can't do that and think you can't get consequences. That like blows my mind. It blows my mind. I will say these people probably don't know that she hit the cop. The cop is trying to explain it. They may not believe him. I totally get that. You're just going on hearsay and stuff. I get it, but. I feel like she playing like she out. Like it's a rap type thing.
And the transport vehicle.
This is pretty much it.
Driver who begins to speak in a moment, and the transport vehicle arrives to hold the driver, waiting for the medics to transport.
Why that man look like Jared Cannonier? Who got any MMA fans? I swear to God, that's Jared Cannonier. He out here playing games.
Stand up, man. Come on. Come on, man. Stand
up. Stand up.
This is the other one right here. The East Circuit. Listen, we already did that one. That video is on my page. These cords. There's too many cords in my life right now. I swear to God. I wish it was women, but it's not. Yo, okay. That was wild. Again, looking at it from a logical standpoint without actually knowing, because every state is a little bit different law-wise, what can and can't be done, what amount of force and stuff like that. I believe it's a little bit different. So I can't say what specifically should have taken place in that place. I don't know. But I will say, could he possibly have subdued her? Sure. Am I mad at him for defending his partner who's getting punched in the face? No, not really. I'm not upset about it. It's one of those things, right? And I think this is where we've kind of, in the world has gone strongly in this direction of like, yes, we could have probably went a different way from hitting her. However, it's like we're negating the fact that she was punching him, that she was right. It's almost like, well, no, we got to protect her though. And I get that. But at the same time, consequences need to be a real thing. Like you need to see consequences for your actions because that's what stops people from doing this stuff. And I'm going to go as far as to say, this is where I think there's a problem with the whole, you can't do any discipline to your kid anymore. Okay. There's two ways of looking at it. When I grew up, I was disciplined. It wasn't a whole bunch. I was never beat up. I never felt like, oh my God, someone was just taking something out of me. None of that. That happens for sure, but it didn't happen to me. So what happened to me, I don't see how this is would be a disadvantage to anybody. Like there's little things that would happen or I would go really crazy about something and I would not listen. They'd be talking to me. They'd try to talk me down. I would not listen. Little slap on the bop. I'm like, woo. Okay. I'm chilling. And Now I'm an older person. I don't have any trauma from any of that. I have morals. I hold the door for people. I have a lot of empathy for people. Like, I mean, maybe it didn't create that. Empathy is something you may or may not have, you know, whatever. But it benefited me, I feel like. Now, obviously, the reason why we're not allowed to do this anymore is because of the people that come home, long day of work, I'm angry. Oh, get out of my way. I'm going to just beat the shit out of you. Oh, you dead. I'm going to beat the shit out of you. Like, that is what was a problem, right? Like, you should never just beat your kid up. Even in a disciplining situation, you should not beat them up. It's meant to discipline. It's meant to learn. It's a lesson. So it's just weird to me that it's like, that is, I get it. But we went extreme. It's like you can't put a finger on your kid anymore because of these people that went to the lengths of beating the shit out of their kids, even though slight discipline was actually helpful. That's just my opinion. I'll never have kids, so you don't have to worry about it. I'm never going to enact anything that I feel. I'm just saying this is my opinion as a kid who grew up, who was disciplined, but was not beaten, I never felt like I was targeted or someone was upset about their day, so they went harder on me. Never, never. It was just specifically I did something wrong. I received a consequence for it. And a lot of times it was just talking. It was really just when I would keep going and I wouldn't listen to what they were telling me, or I wouldn't quiet down, or I just kept having a fit that they would then, all right, listen, boop. And it worked. So I don't know. Listen, I'm just saying there was a little branch off from this video here, but all I'm trying to say is consequences. Consequences are needed. It's the excessive consequences that we need to stop. But stopping all consequences only makes this world worse. I promise you that. I promise you that. Comment below what you guys think. Another video will pop up right here. I appreciate you guys. We also got the Tribe Discovery channel where we watch alien, ancient Egyptian, pyramids, all that stuff. If you guys want to check it out, link in the description. I'll catch you next video, homie.